Welcome. In this video, we'll explore the 5G new radio waveform structure and the main physical downlink channels. We'll also show how to generate a 5G downlink signal using the MATLAB 5G toolbox. This is also the first video in a series where we'll explain each component of the 5G downlink waveform and how a UE connects to a cell. Let's get started with the first section. 5G uses orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, OFDM. In this technique, data is represented on a 2D grid, where the x-axis corresponds to time and the y-axis to frequency. Each column on this grid represents a symbol, and each row corresponds to a subcarrier. In 5G, 14 OFDM symbols are grouped together to form a slot, which serves as a fundamental unit along the time axis. Each individual point on the time frequency grid, defined by one subcarrier over one symbol, is called a resource element. A group of 12 consecutive subcarriers in the frequency domain makes up a resource block, which is the smallest unit of bandwidth allocation. To transmit this data over the air, the grid must be converted from the frequency domain to the time domain. This is done using the inverse fast Fourier transform, a step we explained in one of our earlier videos. Before transmission, each time domain symbol is prepended with a cyclic prefix, a copy of the end portion of the symbol added to the beginning. In 5G, the cyclic prefix of the first symbol in some slots is longer than the others. Now let's talk about subcarrier spacing. In LTE, the subcarrier spacing is fixed at 15 kHz, but in 5G, it's more flexible. Multiple values are possible. This flexibility is defined by a parameter called numerology, which takes integer values from 0 to 4. Each numerology index corresponds to a specific subcarrier spacing calculated using the formula shown on the slide. Applying this formula, we get possible subcarrier spacing values of 15, 30, 60, 120, and 240 kHz. However, in frequency range 1, which includes frequencies below 7 GHz, only the lower values of 15, 30, and 60 kHz are used in practice. Numerology doesn't just determine subcarrier spacing, it also defines how many slots are transmitted within a subframe. So let's take a closer look at the frame structure. A 5G transmission is organized into 10 millisecond frames. Each frame is divided into 10 1 millisecond subframes. Then, depending on the numerology used, each subframe is further split into n slots, where n ranges from 1 to 16. This means higher numerology values with wider subcarrier spacing result in more slots per subframe. Finally, as we discussed earlier, each slot contains 14 OFDM symbols. There's one more key concept related to numerology and subcarrier spacing: bandwidth parts. 5G supports very wide bandwidths, up to 100 MHz in frequency range 1 and up to 400 MHz in frequency range 2. However, not all user devices can handle such wide bandwidths at once. That's where bandwidth parts come in. A bandwidth part is a configurable portion of the total carrier bandwidth. Each BWP can have its own number of resource blocks and even a different subcarrier spacing tailored to the device's capabilities or network needs. The position of a BWP is defined relative to a common reference point called point A, and it's specified in terms of the number of resource blocks from that point. Each user equipment can be configured to monitor up to 4 BWPs, but it can only be active on one BWP at a time. Now that we understand the basics, let's look at the physical channels transmitted in the 5G downlink waveform. The first is the physical broadcast channel. It carries essential cell information that the UE needs to connect to the network. This information is encapsulated in the master information block. Alongside the PBCH, two synchronization signals are transmitted, the primary synchronization signal and the secondary synchronization signal. These are used during the cell search procedure, helping the UE achieve time and frequency synchronization. Together, the PSS and SSS also allow the UE to determine the cell ID. These three signals, PBCH, PSS, and SSS, together form a synchronization signal block. In 5G, SSBs from different beams are transmitted in 5 millisecond bursts, and these synchronization signal bursts are repeated at configurable intervals, for example, every 20 milliseconds. Next, we have the physical downlink control channel. It's typically located within the first one, two, or three symbols of a slot and carries downlink control information. This tells the UE when and where to look for its data on the frequency time grid. Finally, there's the physical downlink shared channel. It occupies the remaining available resources and is the main data-carrying channel, delivering high-speed user data to the UE. Be sure to check out the upcoming videos in this series for a deeper look at each of these channels and signals. Now let's switch to MATLAB and see how to generate a downlink waveform using the 5G toolbox. You can find a link to download the code in the video description below. We begin by setting up the 5G configuration using the NR downlink carrier configuration object from the 5G toolbox. For now, we'll leave all parameters at their default values and move straight to waveform generation. To generate the waveform, we use the NR waveform generator function and pass in our configuration object. This function returns the 5G time domain waveform along with a waveform information object that contains all relevant signal parameters. Next, we plot the generated waveform. To do this, we first extract the necessary OFDM parameters, such as the number of subcarriers and the sampling frequency. We then use a spectrogram to visualize the signal. This plot shows how the frequency content of the waveform changes over time, effectively giving us a view of the OFDM grid. We also save the waveform to a MAT file, which will be useful in upcoming videos, where we simulate a 5G receiver. As you can see in the figure, the result is a typical 5G downlink waveform in the OFDM domain. By default, the configuration fills the carrier with maximum user data. Control signals like PDCCH are not visible and appear between PDSCH allocations. You'll also notice that the subcarriers near the band edges are left empty. This is intentional. In 5G, guard bands are used to protect adjacent channels and reduce interference with other networks. Now, let's modify the configuration to better visualize control channels. We'll define the entire setup in a separate configuration file where we specify two input parameters, the number of subframes to generate and the carrier frequency. First, we create an NR downlink carrier configuration object as before. Then, we set some basic 5G parameters. For example, we define the cell ID, set it to 101, and specify the frequency range as FR1. Next, we configure the number of subframes and the carrier frequency based on the input values. To visualize control signals, we use the NR wave generation PDSCH configuration object to disable user data by setting its enable property to false. We then apply this configuration to our main setup. In the transmitter script, we also make a few updates. We set the number of subframes to 5, the carrier frequency to 3925 MHz, and generate the full configuration using our custom function. Since this waveform doesn't carry user data, we can clearly observe other physical channels. We can identify the synchronization signal blocks transmitted in a burst. We also see PDCCHs, which don't occupy the full bandwidth, which is typical in 5G. And that's it for this video. If you'd like to dive deeper into 5G downlink waveforms, be sure to check out the next video, where we explore synchronization signal blocks and their role in the initial access procedure. Thanks for watching.